They're gone. The Confederate era statues in Baltimore taken down by contractors hired by the Baltimore City government, done in the wee hours of the morning without incidents. Live now to Wyman Park and WBAL News Radio 1090, Scott Wyckoff, who watched it all happen. Scott?
Yes, I did, Brian. It was just after 3 o'clock when I arrived here on the scene, and I saw the Whiting Turner contractors putting a big crane hook onto the statue of Robert E. Lee and Thomas J. Stonewall Jackson here in the park that is just across the street from the Baltimore Museum of Art. They hoisted it in the air, put it on a flat bag, and just about an hour later, just before 4 o'clock, it was all gone, and Vincent was also here watching it happen.
It's just very emotional, very powerful. Very powerful. It says a lot. You know, we still got a long way to go, but this is a great start.
What did you think about the commission's decision and the mayor's decision to have it removed immediately?
I didn't see that coming. I, at the end of the day, I think it was the best decision. Yeah. Yeah.
There were other people here, Brian, who did not agree with him. They thought this statue was a part of Baltimore's history. They were upset that it was removed here this morning. Watching it all happen here this morning, about 10 feet from me, Brian, was Mayor Catherine Pugh. I asked her if she wanted to talk about what she saw. She decided not to, left with her detail. But as you said, she'll be talking about it later today. All that happened here across the city.